in a shallow, unmarked grave. A forensics team is carefully trying to unearth what's buried here. They soon find something. Human remains, wrapped in what was probably once a white cloth, now yellowed with dirt and time.
We're still digging up the graves and exhuming the remains, so we still can't tell you how many bodies there are except for the ones that we found today.
The police suspect there are almost 40 graves in the area. They don't yet know who these people are or how they died, but they are likely to be migrants or refugees who were being trafficked into Malaysia. About 200 meters from the burial site is a camp, its inhabitants long gone.
Authorities say they believe this camp has been abandoned for at least 2 years. Now, much of the structure is already in ruins, but you can see it was probably big enough to hold about 200 people.
All around the camp, there are signs that people lived here. Plates, crockery, basins thrown into a pit, pieces of cloth that may have been curtains, and crudely built cages where trafficking syndicates kept their human cargo. To prevent any escape, they used barbed wire. The camp is on a hill less than 500 meters from the Thai border. It's one of 28 human trafficking camps found by the Malaysian police over the weekend, less than a month after Thai authorities made a similar discovery in their territory. These camps are where traffickers hold their prisoners while they demand ransoms from their family. The majority of refugees are thought to be Rohingya, an ethnic minority persecuted in Myanmar. They escape by sea and are then brought overland through Thailand and Malaysia. Thousands of them are thought to be adrift at sea after police in Thailand started cracking down on human trafficking. Malaysian police at first denied the existence of these camps, but now they say they are investigating what happened. These camps in Malaysia may be abandoned, but there's no indication the human trafficking syndicates have been broken up.